So welcome guys to the third chapter of research methodology. Today we are going to understand what is the research proposal. In the previous two chapters we have seen some basic concept of research, means what do you mean by research, what is the property of research, what is the importance of research, where we are using research, especially in the social science, what is the importance of research in a general way or in a specific way. We have also seen the different type of research. And also we have seen what are the different stages of research, and also we have seen that some basic concept like what do you mean by the research topic, what is the research problem, what are the different sources of research problem, how to generate a research questions, what is the importance of research questions. These things we have seen in our first and second chapter. If you have missed those session, let me tell you to go back and see the two videos which is related with the chapter 1 and 2 before coming to the chapter 3, which is saying about the research proposal. As all the things are totally related with each other and we cannot study those things in isolation. First we have to understand the basic, then we have to move to the further. So I hope you have already done that things. So let us start the today chapters, which is saying the research proposal. Basically research proposal is also known as research planning. Research proposal is also known as synopsis. Research proposal is known as guideline for your actual research. So how we can define the research proposal? It means these are the three things. General, what is research proposal? Importance of research proposal. General format of research proposal. This is the three main things which we have to discuss today. Like if you see here, the research proposal is a blueprint of the proposed project. Means what you want to do, we have to give a proposal, which is in a systematic way, in a written way, in an organized way, so that it will not only give us the guideline. Being a researcher, we can get the guideline from it. Being a stakeholder, the other people who is directly or indirectly involved in our research, they also have the idea what we are going to do in the future. And it is the research proposal is a plan of action and a strategy to be carried out according to the objective of the study. Whatever the objective we have decided in our research proposal, we are going to execute those things as per our plan. It is the plan or the strategy which counts more than it could be carried out in a mechanical fashion. So in a short way, we can say a research proposal is a written plan of a research in an organized and a systematic way. It's a document that is typically written by a scientist, if it is a scientific research or academic. Sometimes academic research, it may be by the students, by the professors for the further study into the field of academic, to describe the idea for the investigation on certain topic. So the research proposal outline the process from beginning to end and may be used to request financing for the project, certification for performing certain parts of the research of the experiment, or as a required task before beginning a college dissertation. So we have seen that the research proposal is all about planning for our research. It helps us to get the confidence into a researcher. It also helps us to get the finance from the financial body, from what you call as a sponsor body. It also gives the idea to a supervisor or advisor of a students that whether the research which is going to be followed is in right track or not. So this is the basic meaning of research proposal. And what is the function of research proposal? If you understand the meaning of research proposal, you can easily define the function of research proposal. Like it provides a guideline to the researcher for adopting the systematic approach toward the solution of a problem. Means being a researcher, if I have some plan about my problem, plan in a sense of which literature I have to be follow, which methods I have to adopt, which technique I have to follow, the things, how many days I am going to be complete this research, how much capital I require for that. If these things I have the idea before starting the research, with the help of my research proposal. It will not only give the guideline, it also build the confidence among the researcher. It provide a basic for the evaluation of the proposal by researchers. It make aware that the researcher of the problem and difficulties he or she will have faced in his study. See, when we have prepared a research proposal, we have seen this type of potential problem may come. It may be related with the actual research area. It may be related with the respondent, it means inability of the respondent, or not showing the interest from the other colleagues. It may be the confusion related with the selection of the procedure. So by avoiding these things in the actual research, we will try to complete these things in our proposal itself. It restore confidence in researcher about the feasibility and worth of his investigation. Of course, when we have the planning, when we have the idea, when we know what is the feasibility, means what is the possibility of this research, what will be the scope of this research, what is the benefit of this research, and what will be the resources required for this research, it automatically builds the confidence from one level to the next level. It stimulates the researcher and move his to the goal of complete his project. Because the researcher knows how much capital it requires, because the researcher knows what will be the, how many people require to complete this one, because researcher knows what is actually my problem is and how much time I have allotted. One more thing which I would like to say over here is, a research proposal doesn't mean you cannot change those plan. If it require, we can go back and change some things in the plan. Like suppose if things which are unexpectedly come, then what to do? So we have to move back and we have to say something or say some modification into a plan so that we can further move to the study. And also, it also enable the advisor to access the progress of work of his advisee at a regular interval. Means if you are an academician or if you are a student who is learning the social science or science, BBA, MBA, MPhil, PhD, whatever, it enables the advisor. Your advisor have the idea whether you are going into right direction or not, whether you are following the proper guideline or not. It will also act as a check and balance. Your functions, your technique must be followed as per the plan. So this is some basic functions of research proposal. And what is the characteristics of a research proposal? Characteristics or nature of research proposal. The first and foremost, the plan should be written down. After proper planning of research, we must written down the plan. So this is the first stage, this is the second stage, this is the third stage, or you can say the under first chapter we have to write this much of things, under second chapter we have done this much of things, after third we have done this much things. Also in the first month, in the second month, in the third month, whatever the going action of plan is there, we must written in the research plan. And also it must be in a detailed form. If you see the second point, the research proposal is the detailed plan of a study. It doesn't mean we can write in two or three pages and we say this is our research plan. No, everything, whatever we are going to do, it must be in a detailed form. Like what is our research problem is. So it must be defined in a detail from where this problem is coming. What is the source of this problem? And if this problem is going to be solved, who is going to be benefited? What is the scope of this problem? What is the objective of this study? What are the literature you are going to be study, or whatever the, how you will develop a conceptual framework about this study. According to the framework, how you decide what type of research it is. So everything must be about the proposal, must be written in a detailed form. Of course, the research proposal is all about the future. So we are writing all the things in a sense of we are going to do, we will do, or researcher is going to study these things, or researcher is planning to do this thing, or researcher will take this action about this particular things. And research proposal is a specific course of action to be followed. Whatever the course of action we are going to do, it must be as per the research proposal. It is document which set out your idea in an easily accessible way. It present a focus and a scholarly present research problem and plan. I hope you understand this point. The objective in writing a proposal is to be described what, why, how, when. As I told you, the research proposal must be in a plan way, in a detailed way. And detailing in a sense, ki, what is my actual problem is, why I am going to study this problem, how we are approaching to the solution, when this proposal or this research is going to be finished, how much capital is required, who is going to sponsor this one. So these are the characteristics of a research proposal. And guideline for research proposal. Actually, research proposal is itself a guideline for your complete research. But while writing a research proposal, what are the different guidelines? Or what are the things we should see before writing the research proposal? You see, guideline for research proposal. A vague or fuzzy proposal can lead to unsuccessful research writing. Vague means the things or the statement which is not leading to you any statement which have some logic, or anything in a general when you saying and it doesn't have any sense for your further study. So that is the vague study statement or a confusing statement. So this type of things should be avoided while writing the research proposal. A good research proposal hints on a good idea. Good idea in a sense, okay, what are the problem you are going to face? If that problem will generate some idea which will be the benefited for the future, then this will be a guideline for a research proposal. Read everything that you can in your area of interest. So there is a one very good saying that when we are going to doing a research, we have only see two things. First, it may be our area of interest. Second, it is our area of study. If both are there, that is well and good. If it is not there, at least whatever the things we are going to our research proposal, we have some area of interest relative to the research, finding missing part of our understanding. Means whatever the things is the gap, find out the missing part of the understanding. It may be through the literature review, it may be through the book, it may be through the some other available resources. Figure out how to build these pieces, how to connect the dots, how to connect the things which is available in different places. What are the sources we are going to use? Leave and breathe the topic. Think about the topic. How you will make it more, not in sense of beautification, but in a sense of more logical. Think in a sense how you will make this topic more attractive in sense of getting the results, more logical, more objectivity. Talk about it with anyone who is interested. It may be your colleague, it may be your boss, it may be the other researcher, it may be the senior researcher, it may be who is involved in your research. So talk about him and get the more idea. Then just write the important part of the. These are some basic guidelines. You cannot say everybody is following the same guideline, but these are some basic guidelines for your research proposal, so that your research proposal will become a guideline for your complete research. If you go further, it is saying that what is not a good proposal. It means sometimes here we are seeing the things. What is not should be included, or what should we consider so that our research proposal should be a good proposal. Sometimes being a researcher, we have done various things and we think that these things will be help us to find out a good research. But being a researcher, we should avoid these type of things, because these are the things which is not considered for your good research proposal. Like if the problem is too broad and complex to be handled in one inquiry. Being a researcher, you think that let me select a topic which is very big, which is very complex, and which will give me a good name in the society or in organization if I'm going to solve that. No, every researcher has a limitation in his knowledge, limitation in his education, limitation in his area of study. So that being understanding all these things, we have to select the topic which can not be very broad. If it is abroad, we have to break down. We can study one by one. Further study is there. Further research is required. Further research is required. The thing is that practically what a researcher can handle, it should be there. Not too broad and too complex. If the problem is too subjective and based on the personal opinion, which cannot be supported by the fact. Sometimes a researcher will take a problem which is too subjective. Subjective in a sense, it's a very general thing. It's a very simple statement of that one. objectivity is not there, specific is not there. It's a general things we are saying, and we are trying to give some personal opinion. Being a researcher, this is the being of the experience, without any without any fact, without any logic, without any proof or experiment, researcher is coming to the conclusion. And this type of subjectivity should be avoided when we are developing a research proposal. If the problem is of highly controversial because of the nature of the materials, one own preconception. Highly controversial may be related with religious issue. Whatever the research you are going to do, it may not be accepted by one group of people. It may be an ethnic group, it may be the political group, it may be the religious group. So being a researcher, we may avoid these things. Even we are going to collect some actual data, or we can prove it, but still those things which are controversial, we should be avoided into a good research proposal. If the problem is too familiar and does not lead to some unknown domain of the knowledge, I have seen many times students come to the research proposal or come with the idea that they want to do the research in that particular field. I ask them, what extra you have going to do it? It is too much exhausted. Already have done too much research in this particular field. If you are going to get the same thing, if you are going to find out the same problem, what new we are going to do, or what new we are going to expect from that one? If there is nothing, then the problem is too familiar and should avoid this type of problem in a good research proposal. If the problem is too technical and of complex nature, of which the researcher has no theoretical background, what I mean to say is that sometimes we are taking the research proposal or a problem from different study area. Like being a student of BBA or MBA, you are going to select a problem related with the BCS or computer science or engineering. It may look good, but maybe it is very technical to you. And same thing is true for them. If the students of engineering or students of computer science, if they are going to take the research related with the motivation, related with the employee satisfaction, related with the econometrics, related with the economic condition of the country. So this type of things are technical for them. So try avoid these things to be a good research proposal. So these are the some things which is saying that that research proposal is not good. If it is very complex, too complex to be handled, too subjective, highly controversial, too familiar and not expected to get anything new, or too technical. What is the importance of research proposal? Means why we have discussed this much till now, but what is exactly research importance? Like since first slides we have seen, a research proposal is going to help the researcher to define the content and to plan and execute as per the guideline of that one. So it is the guideline for the research proposal. First importance, to inform potential collaborator and supporter about the topic and expected quality of the research, or we can say that it is give the confidence to the stakeholder. Being a stakeholder, I must have idea what the researcher is going to be do, what is his plan. The proposal can be submitted to one or more agency for consideration for funding. And sometimes when we are going for our research project fund, banking, the first questions which bank ask is, where is your research proposal? Where is your synopsis? So it is also given to some non-banking financial corporation, NBFC, where they ask, provide us the research proposal. We will see what is the potential of this project, what is the expected outcome of this project, what is the benefit of this particular project, so that we will think about the funding. So it is also important for that one. Justify the choose research project. Describe the current state of knowledge of research topic, considering or important related. Means when we have the research proposal, it means we have some guideline. It means we are going to follow all the next things as per this proposal. So, and also we can justify as per the problem, as per the statement objectivity, as per the specific objective, as per the benefit. We are going to consider all the other things of that one. Also, in the importance of research proposal, define the research strategy and methodology to be used, test the hypothesis or research questions. We have also developed research questions and hypothesis into a research proposal also in itself. Research questions has to be solved in our actual research, and with the help of research questions which is prepared in the research proposal, we are also going to develop our questionnaire. If it is a survey research, also we have to consider while taking the interview. Discuss ethical consideration about the research methodology. Means what are the things ethically right, you should also have to be highlighted into a research proposal. Means especially from a plagiarism point of view, from a government point of view, from a society point of view, what is ethical we should also consider while we are developing our research proposal. Define realistic, feasible, operational planning based on the research market and general conditions. This is coming again and again, because sometimes it has been seen that the people have taken the or written the research proposal which seems very good, which looks very good, but it may not be realistic. Means being a researcher, you are not able to go that one. It may not be feasible in a limited time, in a limited knowledge, with the limited capital. So whatever it is there, it must be, and with the help of research proposal, we can see it, how much realistic it has. And it is the duty of the supervisor or guide, or you can say the some senior advisor who can give, no, these things we have to avoid, or these things we can reduce, or these things only we will focus. Like, inform potential collaborating institution and person about the research project and enable them to identify the kind of support they can give. It may be the our client, it may be the society, it may be the environmental agency where they can support it. It may be our respondent also. So that, and also serve as an important tool for monitoring the research. These all things are the important of research proposal. That's why we are developing a research proposal. And it's a good practice. Being an academician also, it is good practice that first we will ask the research proposal from a students so that we can get the idea. And we can also say that these things you can modify, these things you can change, these things you can go further, or this is accepted for your research study. So it's a very small questions. Why do you need to write a good research proposal? I hope you got the answer till now in last 20 minutes, whatever we have discussed. Why do you need to write a good research proposal? It may be for the approval from our supervisor, you are a student. It may be to get the fund from a funding agency, maybe bank, NBFC. It may be give the confidence to the stakeholder. It may be our client. It may be the our organization, own organization where we are working. It may be the government. Sometimes government also asks the research proposal. It may be for the society. Like sometimes we have to give the some clearance from the environmental. So these are the reasons to write a good research proposal, so that we can get the fund, we can get the certificate, we can get the approval. For who do you think will want to read your research proposal? The same questions. Who do you think want to read a research proposal? First, researcher itself, because it is a guideline for the study. Second, the funding agency, those who is going to give us the fund. Third, client. So that client had the built how much time it will take to complete this particular research. Fourth, it may be the bank. It may be the funding agency. So this is the basic things what we have learned till now. And this is all about the research proposal. Means not all about, but you can say that this is the meaning of research proposal. This is the use of research proposal, characteristics of research proposal, or the nature of research proposal, and what we should avoid while writing a good research proposal. We have seen this particular thing. Now we are going to see the format of research proposal, or you can say the component of research proposal. It is not fixed that we have to follow these things, but there must be some things which you cannot avoid. As we have seen in our characteristics of research proposal, that research proposal is written in a detailed form, written plan in a written form, so this is the some basic titles which is there in the research proposal. Like, as you know, that the title page is there, introduction page, then the chapter 1 or the first part of the research proposal is introduction or the background of the study. Under this one, we have the background of the study, problem statement, hypothesis or research questions, then objectivity, objective of the research. Also, we can write the scope of the research, significance of the research. Then we move to the second part or second chapter of the research proposal, which is the literature review. Here we are considering the previous research related theoretical concept. Then move to the third one, which is known as research methodology, material and procedure. Here we will see what is our study area, what is the total population, how to select the sample, what is the sampling methods, what are the different type of data, how to collect the data, if there are the variables, what are the different type of variables. Further, we will move to the work plan. If our research is for the 12 month, for the 30 month, or for the 2 year, what is the every month plan is, how much budget is required, and finally we will complete the research proposal with references and annexures. So let us see a brief idea about the each things. Like you can see the title page and introduction. Title should have the topic, and generally we are considering the format which is provided by the client or which is provided with the college. Like first page should be your title is there, your name is there, name of your department, faculty, college or organization, name of your advisor or name of your organization, date of starting and expected date of submission. This is the first page. After that, table of contents and something like that. Then in the introduction, the first chapter, we are saying the first chapter. Under that one, the first thing is like 1.1 is your background of the study. Basically, background of the study is different from the problem statement. I have seen sometimes students has made a mistake and they have written the problem there in the background of the study. No, it's not like that. Background of the study is all about how it started. Now what the problem, not what the problem you're facing. Like suppose you are working in an organization and your organization is working in this field, but in this field since 10 years. So you may say background of the study is like that. This organization has been working in this particular field and they are the prominent company or they are the leading company in this particular business. Now, apart from them, there are many other company who is also doing this type of business, and now the competition is very strict. These type of things we can say under the background of the study. And like this type of study also have been done by the previous researcher. You can also say this type of condition was also there in America or in Europe or in India, in many places. So we have to give some basic background. It may be related with the organization, it may be related with the topic, it may be related with the context, so that where we stop the background of the study, we will go further to the problem. I hope you understand what is the background means, how it started, what is the things which ignite this research. Then after ignition, what is your problem? A problem statement is a short description of the issue. Means being an employee, I am working in this organization since 10 years and researcher has faced this problem and he has observed this gap among the two group of people. One group is highly motivated, another group is not motivated. Why this gap is there, or what is the differences between this gap, or how to change this gap, or how to fill this gap? This is your actual research problem. Even we can also write, if the researcher is expected to complete this research and he is going to solve so that the company is going to be benefited in future. Here we have to write this type of things. Then hypothesis and research questions. Basically, hypothesis is the educated guess, where two or more variables have some relationship. Hypothesis we have written in a statement form, in the form of null hypothesis and in the form of null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. Null hypothesis is generally there is no relationship between two variables. Alternative hypothesis is the reverse of that one. And research questions are basically your further division of your topic. Like your topic is one study, one big study, and you want to study and you will break down your topic into 4 questions. These questions, after you have You have the idea when I will complete these four questions with the help of questionnaire, and also research question is helping you to develop a questionnaire. So when I complete this research questions, automatically my research topic is completed. So research questions is your further division of topic in a form of question. And hypothesis is all about the statement about the relationship among two or more variables. We will see these things in a further study. Then in the first chapter itself, we are seeing the objective of the study. Generally, objectives are written in a two form, your general objective and a specific objective. General objective is related with your topic. What is your topic in a detailed way, like in a statement form? If your topic is related with the one specific things, you want to find out the relationship between, or you want to find out the impact of one variables on other variables, so you have to write out like impact of motivation or impact of income on the study on the motivation level of employee in this particular organization. So this detailing or detailed statement of your topic is known as general objective. And further, we will move to the specific objective. Basically, a specific objective must be the same with the research questions. If you have four research questions, a specific objective must be four. Whatever the first research questions, it may be written in that form. So your research objective may be linked with the your questions, research questions, or research hypothesis, but in a statement form. So this is all about chapter number one of research proposal. Means under research proposal, when we are writing the introduction as our chapter number one. Under introduction, we have background of the study, means how it all started. Then problem statement, what is the problem being a researcher you are facing? It may be the practical problem, theoretical problem, general problem, society problem. Then you will develop the research questions or hypothesis on the basis of your topic. Then we will write the statement form of objective of the research. We can also add like significance of the study, scope of the study in the first chapter. After completion of your first chapter in the research proposal, and remember these all things, we are writing in an expected form, in a future tense. Like this is going to be, do like this, we are going to complete. We have the, our researcher have the idea of this. Let me tell you one more thing. Please avoid this type of pronounced word like I, we, you, he, she in the research proposal as well as research report. Generally, we are using a researcher or a group of researcher, being a researcher. So this type of things we are using instead of pronounced. And the second chapter, after the completion of first chapter, second chapter is literature review. Literature review is all about referring the previous materials which is related with your research. It may be some theoretical things or it may be some empirical review. Theoretical in a sense, or the conceptual in a sense, what is the concept behind that? If you are talking about the motivation and satisfaction, then we will see about the what is the motivation, what is the different type of motivation, what is the benefit of motivations. If we are seeing these things and we are including these things, means we are going to take some theoretical idea about these things. Also, which is very important in the literature review, which some students are missing, or they are only focusing more on the conceptual part, means we also have to consider the at least 3 to 4 previous research which is similar to your research or same with your research. Maybe done by other researcher in other place with other situation, no problem, but it will give you the idea this type of research has been done by this particular person in this particular area in this particular time and he got this result with full citation, with full credit given to him. If we are not giving the credit from where we are getting this particular idea, it is a plagiarism. So literature review is all about a scholarly paper, reviewing the scholarly paper which include the current knowledge, or also we are referring the books, we are referring the internet, we are referring the previous research scholar work, and we are citing all these things, literature review. I hope you understand the literature review. We have the separate chapter for literature review. We will see it, how to write it, how to cite them, and how to rephrase the things. You are sometimes we cannot say that XYZ in 2008 has come with this conclusion. We have to rephrase the things also. We should not write all the things the same. Even we are citing, whenever we are referring their name, but still we try to reframe the sentence in our own word in the literature review. Then the third chapter, with the help of your introduction, with the help of your problem, with the help of your objective, with the help of literature review, we are going to develop a research method. Under research methods, we are seeing about the research area, the study area. We will see in what places this particular area is there, what is the geographical condition of area, what is the population, what are the people doing there, what is their main work. So this is small things we have written in the study area. And a study design, on the basis of your problem, on the basis of your questions, on the basis of your expected outcome, we will see what type of research it is. It may be our descriptive research, it may be in exploratory research, it may be explanatory research. What type of research is it? We have to say in the research design. And also we will see what is the total population, how much sample we are going to select from this total population, what is the sample size, and how we will select sample, means what is the sampling procedure or what is the sampling methods. So these things, like the study area, research design, population, sample size, sampling method, different type of data, means we are going to select the data through a questionnaire, so primary data, we are going to select some data through secondary sources, also secondary data, how we are collecting this data through a survey. Then description of a variables. If you have the variables, we have to define how many variables are there, in which category they belong to. So these things we are doing into a chapter number 3. So let me tell you what are the main things. Chapter number 1 is all about the introduction. Chapter number 2 is all about the literature review, means referring the previous work of the other researcher or through the books to get some conceptual idea. Then third chapter is all about the research design, means what type of research it is, what is the total population, what are the sample size we are going to select, how you are going to select the sample, sampling procedure, then what type of data you are going to use, different type of data, method of selecting the data or collecting the data. Then if there is variables are there, what type of variables, different type of variables belong to which category, dependent variable, independent variable. So we have to write these things. Further we move and we will say about the, sometimes we are writing the chapter 4, but sometimes we are giving without any chapters, we are saying the research work plan example. Like this is one of the plan structure for a 6 month research work. Like in the first month or in the month of May and June 2014, the gentleman has or researcher has developed the questionnaire sampling. Then in the month, next month is going for the data collection. The data collection is for the 2 months. Then proposal writing. We can also do proposal writing first or that one. This is the way how we have the plan, a research plan for that one. In this month we are going to do, this month is going to expected these things, thesis completion, presentation, everything will be there as per the plan, and plan must be there, research plan must be there in the research proposal. Budget is all about your how much expected capital is required, how much expected money is required for your proposal, for your project, means it must be justified, means if the 6 month is there, it may be the researcher salary, it may be the remuneration of the other people who is involved in the research, it may be the traveling cost, it may be the equipment cost, it may be the help from the other people, it may be the paper cost, it may be the instrument cost, everything which will be there, it must be written in a detail that this is the expected cost and that will be the budget for your research. And it will also give the idea at how much plus minus cost is there for research. And references, at the last, references, generally in the chapter number 1, we are citing some other work, and also the total chapter number 2 is all about your literature review, means referring the other people's work, or referring the other books, or referring the what you call as internet or secondary data sources. So here we are writing in a complete citation written in a complete form is called as reference. There are the different way of writing the citation in a reference part. It may be the APA style, which we are following being a social science students, we are following the APA style. There are MLM style also there. There are Chicago style also there. There are different type of styles also there. But we will see what the American Psychological Association style is, and we must follow that one. There are the many websites which will give you the total idea of that one. And all cited or all citation must be written in the reference part. Another one more thing is there, which is called as appendix or annexures. And in the annexures, we put the questionnaire, we put the map, pictures, if is there, or any extra things which we think that our stakeholder need to be studied or need to be seen, or some any proof we will put into the extras, annexures, especially questionnaire, map, pictures, diagram, not the figure related with the table and charts, all must be there in the texts, but these type of things you will put into the annexures. So I hope you got the some basic idea related with the research proposal. Under this one, we have a study some basic things like what is the research proposal, what is the function of, like what is the research proposal, then what is the function of research proposal, characteristics or nature of research proposal, how to write a good research proposal, means guideline for research proposal, what we should avoid while writing a proposal so that it should be a good proposal, what is the importance of research proposal, means where we are using this research proposal, importance of research proposal, then component of research proposal. There are three major components, like the introduction part, literature review, and research methodology. Further, we also have to decide the work plan for a 6 months, if research is for the 6 months, for the 1 year, if the research is for the 1 year, whatever the research timing is allotted. Then we will see about the expected expenses in the form of budget. And finally, we will complete our research proposal with references and annexures. I hope you got this particular chapter in a nutshell. And what I'm expecting with you people, that before coming to the class on Saturday, you have been completed and you have seen this video, so that you, whatever the questions coming to your mind, you will ask those things related with this chapter or even with the chapter number 1 and 2. So any doubt, any clarification must be clear in the class. So, but the condition is that you should have to see this video first. If anything I missed, you may ask there. Or if you have any further questions related with the research proposal, and in the class we will discuss with the help of one sample research proposal, and we also try to develop our research proposal with the help of one research problem. So till then, best of luck for you. Thank you very much for watching this.